everyone, it's Kema. We're here today to do a little bit of chair yoga. So all you're gonna need is that chair, maybe something to drink. Well, let's go ahead and get started. So come to a comfortable seat in your chair. I like to come forward enough that I can find a place to get all four corners of my feet down on the ground. If that makes you feel a little unsteady, you can scoot back a little and even be up on your toes. And that actually activates your core a little. I want us to sit up very, very, very tall. We're gonna take arms down by our side, roll the shoulders out of your ears. Let's take a deep breath in and a nice long breath out. Take another deep breath in. Nice long exhale out. And one more time. Deep inhale in, nice long exhale out. Let's start to add some movement. Let's start to roll our shoulders. So bring those shoulders up by your ears and then press down. We're rolling up and then bringing them back and rolling them down. Let's do a couple more with breath. Let's start to inhale up and then exhale down. And your breath's like a big circle. There's no stops. There's no starts. We're just going to keep it like a nice circle. And let's go back the other way. Lift up, over, and down. Lift up, over, and down. And take it up, over, and down. Now take that left arm and squish it up towards your ear. And then let's press it down. And then with your right arm, squish up towards your ear and bring it down. And now I want you to try to squish your ears with both shoulders. Lift up, and then exhale down. And bring them up. And exhale down. And one more time. Take them up. Exhale down. All right, let's go ahead and give it a good shake. Let's do a simple twist. We'll go right hand over to your left knee. We're gonna take left hand behind us, get as tall as you can, and then start to turn. If it feels good, go ahead. Continue to look back over your shoulder. Don't feel pressure to do that. We're going to stay here, take a couple of breaths. And then let's turn back to center. Go ahead and take that left hand over to your right knee. Right hand behind, inhale, get tall. Exhale, start to rotate. You can look back over that shoulder. Continuing to breathe. And then let's come back all the way to center and start to tap our legs out. So I want us to start to work from the head all the way down to our feet, all the way back up. So the first thing we're going to do is sit tall, shoulders out of your ears. Go ahead, bring your chin down towards your chest. And let's take a few rolls to the left. So we're rolling around. I'm very conservative when I roll to the back, dropping my chin to the chest. You can coordinate your breath here, but I'd rather you go slow and take two breaths and really enjoy the movement than to rush. Let's do one more. And then when your chin comes around, it starts to hit your chest. Let's roll back the other way. All the way around. So you're listening here, feeling here for any limitations in the range of motion that you may have, just to take note of that to see if it's something that we can work out through some exercise. Let's lift our chin up. So we're going to take those arms up to first, warrior one, and then we're going to look to the left and drop our arms to warrior two. So palms are going to come down, look over your left hand, warrior two. Turn your palms up, inhale. Exhale, look over that right shoulder as you come to warrior two. We'll inhale, bring them up, exhale, looking over that shoulder. So the arms are fun to do, but if this makes your arms tired or your range of motion doesn't work as well, then what I want you to do is just focus on looking over that left shoulder, looking over the right shoulder. So last time, gonna hold here, warrior two arms. You're glancing out over that ring finger on your left hand, looking out to the left, breathe, roll your shoulders down. Let's bring our hands down, and then we'll take them back up. We're gonna look over, ring finger on that right arm, warrior two, hold and breathe. And let's float down. All right, go ahead, give your shoulders a big old roll for me. And shake everything out. All right, so let's take left ear and just bring our left ear towards left shoulder. And then we're gonna lift up. And then we're gonna bring right ear towards our right shoulder. And then bring it up. Can we add breath? Inhale, get tall. Let's exhale, fold left ear to left shoulder. Inhale up. Exhale, so you're just dropping that ear towards the shoulder. Everything else is staying nice and still. And up. One more time. Now let's hold. So we have left ear towards left shoulder. Let's take our left hand and just place it up on our head. We're not applying any pressure here. The hand is just resting on the head. If you would like a little bit more of a stretch, take that right arm and bring it down to your mountain pose. Palm forward, fingertips reaching towards the ground, maybe out at a little angle. Everything that we do today should feel good. No pain. If this doesn't feel good, you're going to either come a little less deep into the pose or out of it altogether. Let's do the other side. So we'll bring ear towards shoulder. Right hand comes up, just lays on top of that head. No pressing. Hand is just heavy. You want a little more. I'm going to bring my hand all the way out to mountain. And release. Go ahead and roll your shoulders. Shake it out for me. All right. So let's bring this. Starting to work our trunk a little. We're going to do that through some modified sun salutation. So one thing I do want to say to you, if you have issues in your low back and you're limited in your deep dive, you can bring your hands right here to your thighs and bring chest up. You're at about 45 degrees. This could be your forward fold. When we rotate, I can bring my hands down across and take my arm up or up. But for those of you who do like to slide a little closer to the floor, please feel free to do so. I'm going to start very conservatively and work my way down. So if you want to come with me, come with me, or take variations that suit you. Starting in mountain pose, all four corners of the feet, big toe, little toe, heel, heel, let's press those down into the ground. Press our sits bones into the chair, sit tall, and bring our palms forward. Roll the shoulders out of your ears. Here's Tadasana, our mountain pose. We're gonna inhale, arms up. Exhale, I'm gonna bring my arms out to the side for this range of motion and bring my hands right to my thighs. I'm gonna take an inhale and lift that breastbone up and away from my belly button. Shoulder blades out of my ears are pressing together. Okay? And then we are gonna go from here. We're gonna lift the left hand, take a rotation. Once again, if the arms getting tired, modifications, and come down, take that time, inhale, get long, exhale, rotate, not holding our breath, we'll bring it down, inhale, flat back, arms up and around, find that Anjali Mudra above your head, hands down to your heart. Okay, so this one I'm going to take a little deeper. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, I'm going to fold it out now and touch my shins. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, bring it down. Inhale, flat back. Exhale, left hand rises. You breathe. good to pause, and then hands will come down. Inhale, get long. Exhale, rotate. I've got that front palm on my shin. And then down we come. Inhale, flat back. And then arms all the way up and around. Find Anjali Mudra. Exhale, bring your hands down to your heart. Last time, so I'm going to go a little deeper. Inhale, arms up. This time, I'm going to come down and I'm going to curl down because this feels good to me and it's okay for my back. I'm going to curl down. Inhale, flat back, lifting chest. And now I'm going to put my right hand down towards the ground and lift that left arm up. Breathing, staying long, hand down. Inhale, get long. Exhale, take it up. And bring it down. Inhale, flat back. Arms up all the way around. Let's bring hands down to heart. We're going to come all the way to mountain pose. Palms forward. Roll your shoulders. Let's take a moment here. Close our eyes. Press into mountain pose. I want you to take a deep inhale in. Exhale out. We're breathing through the nose. Now start to count in. Inhale for four. Exhale for four. Again, inhale. Exhale. One more time, steady breath. Inhale. Exhale. So we want to keep that breath, that steady breath, as we move through some lateral folding and some standing seated poses. So for lateral folding, I'm gonna scooch back in my chair just a little. For me, this chair is high. I have to be on the ball of my feet. Flat foot, great. If you're up on your toes, great. Make sure your chair is nice and sturdy, and I want that to be your number one thing, is that we remember in yoga, we have to find this place where we are steady before we can elongate into our poses. We've got our alignment, okay? Then what we want to do is be balanced, and then we can elongate into this pose. I'm going to go ahead and take my arms up. I like to work from here. Once again, if this is becoming too much on your arms, keep arms down and you can just work here. We're gonna try to stretch these obliques in our intercostals and our ribs a little. So important for deep breathing is to make sure that we're doing things that stretch the side body so those intercostals can help our ribs expand, our lungs expand, okay? So, arms up, inhale. I'm gonna start to take my left hand down towards the floor and my right arm over a little. I don't want to go so far that my right hip starts to come up or I start to lean out of my chair. I'm gonna bring my hand down for self-awareness, that kinetic response. You can take your thumb to your bottom rib, expand your hand down so your long finger touches the top of your hip, and then squeeze those fingers together to help you remember to activate these muscles as you come up, okay? So arms up. We won't do it that slow each time. And let's drop down. I'm gonna start to roll that left arm back. And then inhale up. Exhale, fold, roll that right shoulder back. Inhale up. Exhale, fold. You're going to take a breath here. So that's an entire breath cycle. An inhale, exhale. And then an inhale, bring it up. All right, roll your shoulders. Let's have some fun with our standing poses. So coming down into those hips. Let's take the left knee up. I'm holding right underneath my left leg and I'm just gonna draw a few circles. For my people that may have any hip precautions, I want you to follow your hip precautions. That's if you can't cross your legs, internal, external rotation. If those things aren't right for you, then I just want you to come here and maybe do some gentle up and down squeezes. If you're circling with me, let's reverse our circle. Okay. Just trying to warm into those hips a little because they're really going to help us in our standing poses. Let's bring foot down. All right, other side, I'm lifting. I'm going to start to rock. Stay tall in that posture. And anytime you need to get a sip of something to drink, you go ahead and do it. I'm going to go back the opposite way. Alright, and let's just tap it out. Now let's come back to this left leg. Let's reach around. You're either going to grab underneath or reach around if you can and release your fingers. And let's lift that knee as high as we can to our chest. This is all dependent on your flexibility in those hips. So if you're here and it feels good, stay there. Everybody else, bring it down. Other side, lift, stay tall. We'll have a curling version of this pretty soon. And bring it down. All right, guys, tap your feet out. So here we go. Let's start with the left side. Let's lift that left leg up and open it out. So as much as you can, you're going to have your legs at 90 degrees for this. Okay, so we're going to do a little warrior one, warrior two, float through. 90 degrees, bring them in if you need to. Have those knees headed in the same direction as your feet. Let's turn towards me, towards your screen, and inhale your arms up, warrior one. Palms are facing each other, up. You can have some nice circle arms. You'll just be here. Warrior one. Now that move we made for warrior two, palms down, we're gonna look out, moving the arms, the torso staying towards me. I'm gonna look over my left hand. So, palms up, warrior one, head towards me. Keep your torso towards me as you come, warrior two. Warrior one. Warrior two. Can we pause here and do a nerve glide? So turn your palms towards me. Turn your head towards me. Roll your shoulders out of your ears. Let's take the fingers on our front hand, our left hand, and move them towards the back. Let's take our fingers on our back hand and move them forward. And then tip your head towards that back arm. Feel that stretch. Oh, I need that. I hope you guys need that as much as I do. Come up. Let's reverse. So front hand goes forward, back hand goes back, head still tips towards the back. Oh, you may really feel it here. And then come back, warrior two, palms down. Look over your hand. Let's everyone bring that left arm down to our thigh and reach that right arm up and over, side angle. So once again, you're going to have a chance here to get a little deeper. Right now, let's stay tall. So roll that right shoulder back and breathe. Option to be at your waist. And let's bring it up. Go ahead and bring that left hand down to the back of the chair for me. Turn your right knee on the chair. Turn your left hand up and start to stretch that arm up and back. Let's reverse our warrior. Keep this back shoulder out of your ear. You ready? Let's take this to our deep side angle. Nice arms as we come up through warrior two. And then I'm going to slide my arm down the inside of my leg. You come to where is appropriate. If you want to come with me, I'm going to try to come down towards the floor. Watch this little trick. I'm going to come up on my toes so I can touch my ankle and feel like I'm down on the ground. Okay, so come as low as you want. If you're up on your toe, you'll feel that little stretch in your calf. And then let's bring it up. Okay, guys, let's take this knee, bring it all the way up and in. Oh, you're over on the side of your chair. We're gonna chair walk. Chair walk. So this is I always told you guys weight shifting was gonna come in handy one day. Now that we're all cooped up in the house, maybe sitting more than usual, I hope you guys will remember to do in your chair walks. Get those glutes up, get them up. make sure you're getting up every 5 minutes on 30 minutes. That's not scientifically based. I think it's a good time. Make sure that you're getting up. Get off those glutes. We don't wanna sit on our glutes all day. All right, you ready for this? Back to warrior one, arms up. We're flowing, warrior one, warrior two, warrior one, warrior two, warrior one, warrior two. One more time. Inhale it up. Exhale. These don't, let's do a couple more because these don't have to look like me. These are your inhale, your exhale. I would like you to try to deepen your breath to your deepest expression. Let your breath be guided by your movement. And then let's come to warrior two. Let's turn our palms forward. All right, so let's take our right hand towards the back, left hand towards the front, and we're going to tip our head back. And let's come back, palms forward, hands neutral, eyes towards me. Front fingers are going to go forward, back fingers will go back, you're going to tip. And then we'll come up. Let's come to high side angle. So let's bring that right arm down. Left shoulder rolls back. Arm up and over if you can. If you need to hold it down, you're going to hold it down. So I could be here if I need to. We're going to reverse. So let's try to inhale as we lift. Turn towards that right arm, lift it up, little fold back, breathe. And now let's come to a deep guy. Let's come up, let's roll down, roll your shoulder back. We're gonna lift heel and stretch. Nice deep breaths. And then let's inhale up. All right. Go ahead, bring your feet in. So what I want you to do for me is keep doing that shifting movement. Shift back and forth, back and forth. All right. Let's go ahead and take one stand. So stand to sit. How we're going to do stand to sit is more in a yogic way than we do in our SIlverSneakers class. Same principles though. If you don't want to stand and sit, you can make this shape and isometrically contract yourself to kind of get a benefit without actually getting up. You're kind of pre-working, pre-gaming for it. Bring your feet back just a little. And I want you to think about your knees over toes, nose over knees. We take our arms up and we come forward almost 45 degrees. This is awkward chair. And right now you're doing it, even with your glutes on the chair. I want you to activate your feet. So big toe, little toe, heel, heel. Press into the ground. Engage your abs. So if that means suck your belly in a little, engage those abs. Now stretch like you're going to stand up so that you're contracting in those quads. Squeeze. This is awkward chair. If you would like to continue to lift your glutes up off the ground, notice my feet, wide base of support. Okay, I'm gonna bring this down. Sit down lightly and bring my arms back. Let's do it again. Let's come forward. Stay, or see if you can lift up to your awkward chair. So I'm looking at you, but I want you to keep your eyes focused directly in front of you, 90 degrees down. Reach through the crown of the head, lift those arms just a little more, and then sit. Guys, let's go ahead and tap our legs out. We're done with that, okay? Let's move down into our lower body. Let's do a nice neutralizing twist. Let's just do a baby twist. Right hand, left knee. Hand, left hand behind you. Inhale, get tall. Exhale, rotate. Steady breathing. If you want to look back a little more, you can. And let's come back to center. Inhale, let's change sides. Inhale, get long. Exhale, take a little rotation. Inhale, get long. Exhale, rotate. And let's come back to center. All right, let's get all the way down into that lower body. We're going to start with our left side. We're going to do some extension and flexion of that knee. So what we're going to do is take our left leg. We're going to extend it out with a flexed foot. So extend it out, flexed foot, all the way. And then bring it back in. Try not to touch the ground. Try to go up like you're trying to touch underneath that chair. Take it straight as you can. And bring it in. So I can make this vinyasa. Still with a flexed foot. Inhale as I straighten. Exhale as I bend. Now, here's a place where we can play. It's very neat. So right now, when you take your leg straight, and then when you bring it back, you're going through your full range of motion. I want us to do this with inside our range of motion. So let's point our toe now. We're going to inhale, point the toe, but don't straighten your leg all the way. Keep it a little bent and point forward. Now flex your foot as you bring it in, but only bring it in line with that left leg. Point, take it up just a little. Flex, bring it back in line. Point, take it up just a little, one more. And flex, bring it in. Now hold under that left leg and let's roll our ankle. We'll roll it one direction. We're going to roll it in the other direction. We're going to flex our foot and point our toe. And flex our foot and point our toe. Spread those toes. Flex foot. And then let's pull that knee up, and now I want you to hunch over like you're doing your cat stretch and really get a stretch here. Pull it in. And then bring it down. Let's tap it out. All right, let's try to remember that on the other side. So first, full range of motion with the flexed foot. So take it up all the way to your extension, all the way back, maximum flexion, trying to take it back behind that chair if you can. Flexed foot. All right, let's go ahead and add vinyasa in. Let's take inhale, exhale. Draw those breaths out for me. We want, in this time, any breathing exercise you do, I feel you can help. That will help you keep your lungs working. You can look breathing exercises up. There's lots of respiratory therapists out there online that have credible information. Just make sure you are looking at your source and it's just not what your cousin, sister's friend said. Go and try to find respiratory sources. I'll try to find those and throw them up on my Facebook for you guys. All right, let's bring it in. Now, little range of motion, point your toe. Don't go up all the way. Flex it as you come back, only to that left leg. Bring it up. Flex it back. Bring it up. Flex it back. Bring it up. Flex. Take it up. Bring it back. Hold on to your leg. Maybe if you need to, start to roll your ankle in one direction. Roll your ankle in the other direction. Point and flex your foot. And then let's pull that knee up. Give it a stretch. Go ahead, bring your feet down. Give yourself a good tap out. All right, let's Let me see how we're doing on time. We're almost done. Okay, guys, one more thing. Take your feet out. Let's lean down that left leg and just give ourselves a little bit of tap. So these are super light taps. Super light taps, just to make sure that we are getting our skin stimulated. Come up that thigh, nice little taps. Let's go down the other side. Tap, 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 tap. So if you take anything that makes you bruise easy, and I want you to be really light when you're tapping yourself. You don't need to worry your family member with bruises in this time. Tap that belly just a little. Tap, 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 tap. We're only, we'll go up our arms. We're only gonna do our collarbones today, okay? Let's do collarbones and ribs. Okay, so we're going to tap for help. So remember, take two fingers, come to the collarbone. We're going to tap from inner, outer on your collarbone. So tap, 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 tap. And we're just thinking about our wellness. It's funny because every time I look over here,